CP Gurnani joins us now. CP Gurnani is represents Tech Mahindra. Let's connect with him to understand what is the way forward for IT companies and what is the way forward for Tech Mahindra person. Mr. Gurnani, good morning. Thank you for joining us. I'm going to start first with a big picture question. What is the way forward for IT companies? A lot of normalization has happened. Things are not looking as scary as they were, let's say, a couple of months ago. How would you define the new normal and the new reboot for the Indian IT sector?
I think most of us have remained safe, remained healthy, but this is a pandemic which has impacted a few lives and as well as a few locations. I can only say is that the command and control center of the company is constantly monitoring the well-being of the employees.
When we spoke last time, Mr. Gurnani, things were in a mess. Nobody knew that how IT companies would adopt. Nobody knew that, you know, whether vendors would be allowed to operate from work at home. But things have normalized. And we know that for financial sector, for telecom sector, two large sectors which Indian IT companies, in a sense, have been associated with, there have been no large bankruptcies or no large casualties. On the medical front also, things are looking better now. So what is your understanding of what the situation was in the month of March versus what it is now?
You know, if you recall last time, I had shared with you that I believe there will be two quarters of stress. And if the second wave is not that strong, and we will live in a suspense till the vaccine is discovered, I think overall global IT spend will come up. If I put everything on a balance, technology will drive the economic recovery. Technology will drive the way consumption is driven. So I remain optimistic, but at the same time, I'm conscious that manufacturing sector, travel, logistics, hospitality, are some of the sectors which are reinventing themselves to be future ready. And we are helping our clients to cope with the post-COVID world.
Let's talk about IT budgets, client engagement. What is the update on that front? Are clients ready to adopt to the new normal? Are they telling you that we need more IT services, we need more digital adoption, more automation, because they also have to be wary of cutting cost and also keeping people safe? In the month of March, clients were not ready to engage because they were themselves trying to protect their businesses, their families and their employees. Has that engagement, have conversations started?
So let's dissect it a bit. What has happened? We're all seeing an increased demand from sectors like telecom, healthcare, pharmaceuticals, media and entertainment, and e-education. So that is a positive side. The second positive side is growth of digital economy. That need for digitalization is become equally important for the corner shop or the grocery shop or, you know, some of the, because people now want to participate in the digital economy. Even retail sector, which was stressed, has proven that the stress is only for offline, but online retail sector is doing well. So I can only say is technology and online services are playing a critical role during lockdown, during slowdown, during COVID-19. And in a lot of ways, the feeling of optimism is relative. And the relative part is that, yes, we continue to see demand.
The high-tech area, it is a very differentiated vertical that accounts for nearly 50% of your total business, according to your classification. What's the update there?
So what we are noticing in these sectors is that they were always digital. So there is no new wave of digitalization as such. what has happened in this sector is the focus is on keeping the lights on, because this sector is right now probably seeing their revenue uptake in data by almost 400%. But at the same time, some of their business users are not doing so well. So in a lot of ways, I would say that if I were to fast forward and look at the next few quarters also, I think technology, media, entertainment, and telecom sector will do well.
Now, Mr. Gurnani, telecom vertical, something which has been very volatile. So what in a sense was adding volatility to your performance, given what the challenges in the telecom sector were? Do you think what was a volatile vertical for you is now going to be the driving vertical for you? Because globally, we know that both spend in telecom and data is only going to intensify. So are you in the right position to really capitalize on it? And where do you see the telecom business moving for Tech Mahindra?
Actually, a lot will depend on the next quarter results, because all of us understand that the new age technologies like 5G, AI, machine learning, data analytics, cloud, automation will be the drivers for change and growth for the telecom businesses. Now, how do we translate it into revenue will depend upon how these organizations respond to the economic development, or in certain cases, a little bit of a slowdown in economy. Please remember, you know, at this stage, the stimulus money has kicked in. US is, what, about 17-18% deficit. India would be about 7-8% deficit. Now, the more the, if you follow the money, and if you look at the digital requirements, I think there is business to be had, but a lot depends on how the world responds over the next two quarters.
One broad question, Mr. Gurnani, on Tech Mahindra. Now, Tech Mahindra comes from the Mahindra group of companies. Yet, whichever way I cut and dissect the current valuations, the P multiple, what markets are giving it, the margins, what Tech Mahindra currently is working with, they're not the best in the industry. So markets are not rewarding you with the best P multiple, and your margins also are not the best in the industry. Why is that?
I think it is a very valid question, and my board has also asked for a plan which addresses three parts to what Tech Mahindra will do. Number one is the industry mix. Number two is geography mix. I think one of our biggest challenges was, which is an advantage as well as a disadvantage, my US business is only 45-48%. Rest of the world obviously is 55%. Now that has effectively meant the energies which have gone into operating in Latin America or operating in Africa could have been better used. So we are now working on a plan which is, number one, geographic reach, number two, service offerings, and number three, some of our big bets like 5G, they've been relatively slow. But I committed to my board that we do understand the challenges. We are going to follow the path of differentiated, connected solutions strategy. At the same time, I mean, I think we need to do a better job of choosing a few of the geographies, particularly where we have now learned that because of the local policies, the local labor policies, it becomes very, very difficult to operate, you know, profitably. So I think, Nikunj, we are conscious of the need for turnaround or transformation. We are very clear. We know the direction. Now I need to bring in the speed.
Transformation, Mr. Gurnani, will happen for Tech Mahindra. Whatever you're sharing is going to be music to the ears of your shareholders. But what shareholders would also ask is that, has the COVID crisis really pushed your plans forward by 6 months or 12 months?
I promised myself that I would, I normally do my financial analyst meet in November. God willing, we will do it physically, but if not, when we do it virtually, I would give more definitive answers. Till that time, because of the uncertainty called COVID, I want to reserve my comments, but I did share with you that strategy, direction, and speed, all three are high on my radar.
What is your view on work at home, Mr. Gurnani? Because different companies are sharing different things. And when I say different companies, I'm comparing off your peers. TCS is saying by 2025, 75% of the workforce will work from home. We've not got a similar indication from Wipro or Infosys. They're saying that whatever transition has happened is largely because of compulsion and it may not be the new normal. At Tech Mahindra, what is the new normal? How much work at home migration will happen and how much migration is currently temporary?
93% people today are working from home. About 6 or 7% go to work, which also because there are clients in Australia, Philippines, some in US who have restrictive and more stringent policies. So I think till December, the ratios are not going to dramatically change. Most of the clients have accepted that work from home is a reality. The positive action to all of this is that most of us are now becoming a lot more conscious about data security, cyber security, and making sure that we use tools and we use the equipment which are part of the Tech Mahindra ecosystem, because clearly the last thing you want is the risks of too much of distributed processing. So work from home as a future, my guess is about 25 to 30% is given. People like me would still go to office because we like to interact with people. We like to, have some cooler conversation. We like to go into the canteen and ask people for feedback and listen to them. Similarly, I like to visit my customers. So I think about 25 to 30% at any given point of time will be home. About 2 days in a week, people would like to come back to work because the structured interactions, the whole human, machine technology refresh will happen those 2 days a week. So interesting time, but the new normal is here to stay.
So because of the wall of work from home, which IT companies are now trying to adopt, could there be a big reboot on SG&A cost, visa cost, the on-site offshore model, which in a sense is a model which also depends on travel, working from site for clients. Will there be a significant reduction there?
In a lot of ways, if you notice that most of the Indian IT companies, despite being a $181 billion business, had stopped investing a lot on campuses. Reason was very simple. Most of the growth was coming, which was, non-linear growth. Number two, it is also evident is that if 25% of the workforce, let's assume, is common for everybody, then we do not need commercial space for a long time. The third part is, it is not that the employee cost or the infrastructure cost will come down dramatically. The reason is that now you will have to start providing some level of allowances which compensate because people are not spending their time and energy from coming to the workplace. So in balance of things, I think it's a good thing for the industry. It's a great thing for the gig economy. It is almost a wonderful thing for a flexible workforce. And it's a wonderful thing for adoption of AI and machine learning.
What is your outlook on India-specific business, Mr. Gurnani, for IT companies? It's not large. I mean, no Indian IT company gets even 10% of the business from India. But what's your outlook there?
I think most of us are hesitant also about India business because NASSCOM has been trying to persuade various government departments that the payment terms, I mean, unfortunately what has happened is that IT buying is almost like they used to buy hardware, where the manpower cost was probably 6 or 7%. Now today the manpower cost in any IT project is 60 to 70%. So the payment terms and the way acceptance of the solution is addressed, I think Indian government has not adopted itself to the new normal. And we have seen it in the last 2-3 years that the Indian IT spending may have gone up, but the players which are participating have only got very limited. And the limited are more state government, smaller players. They like to engage in bigger contracts. Or the some of the large contracts like Passport Seva Kendra is, if you recall, it is a complete system integration project, and somehow your own capability to work with the government on citizen services where the cash flows are protected, it becomes part of the contract. So I think in India Incorporated in IT needs to spend more. India Incorporated has to realize the need for cloud, need for cyber security is very high. And at the same time, India Incorporated has to take into account that whether we like it or not, employee payroll has to be delivered every month. And you cannot have a situation where I work for a project and get paid after a year.
And Indian IT companies are now struggling to come back into double-digit growth. There were some attempts which were made by big companies where they were confident of going back to double-digit growth. But do you think COVID now has really pushed back all hopes of a double-digit growth for next 2 to 3 years?
You know, I mean, in a stable, mature economy, I think the 7 to 8% growth that Indian IT industry has shown, I think we should be very, very happy about it. Somehow, I don't know how the expectation got set that the Indian IT industry will continue to grow forever. Again, as I said, $181-182 billion of Indian IT industry only shows that industry is doing well. If there is any pushback to anything, it is a quarter or two. It is not that the demand has gone up. Demand has gone up dramatically. The demand has not gone up dramatically. However, the need for technology digitalization is on a high. So there is still what I would say advantage Indian IT industry.
Well, Mr. Gurnani, appreciate your time. Thank you for joining us.